Welcome to the class Phonetics, Phonology and Transcription for German teachers of English. Would you like to be welcomed like this by your English teacher? Do you like the idea that someone who teaches English might perhaps not speak exactly like this, but has little or no idea about what went wrong in my introduction? Well, to avoid such an awful standard of speaking and teaching English, it is of utmost importance for students who want to become English teachers and whose mother tongue is German to understand the phonological principles of both English and German. And this exactly, plus several additional aspects, is the focus of our class. So welcome once more to my presentation about the Phonetics, Phonology and Transcription class for future German teachers of English. I will start my presentation about the Phonetics, Phonology and Transcription class first of all by looking at the class description and the syllabus. We will then discuss the educational principles involved in our class, and finally I will introduce you to the class requirements students have to fulfill in order to get the class credits. The class is subdivided into three parts. After an introduction to the main goals of phonetics, with a strong focus on articulatory phonetics, we will concentrate on the phonology of present-day English. This includes the discussion, exemplification and practicing of the transcription of present-day English with words in isolation and in context. The last part of the class is the language-specific extension for Germans. We will first deal with the sound system of German and then compare it with that of present-day English. This comparison enables us to work out the difficulties for German speakers of English, as well as finding remedial strategies for those pupils that have difficulties with the pronunciation of English. A brief look at the varieties of English with their main phonological differences constitutes the focus of our last unit. The whole class is organized in such a way that the online content, that is multimedia and video, serves as the prerequisite for our in-class meetings, where we will practice using a wealth of exercise material. And if you want to take part in our class as a remote online student, then model solutions and additional online help will be available instead. To realize this highly ambitious goal of e-teaching and e-learning, we need a special approach towards education. Let us look at this approach that flips the phases of content delivery and content acquisition in more detail. It is referred to as the inverted classroom model, and here on this little photo you see three people who are involved in this model: Dan Spencer from Detroit, Aaron Sams from Colorado, and myself. We met at the first German ICM conference in February here at the University of Marburg. Alternative terms for this model are flipped classroom or flipped mastery education model. Now, how does this model work? Let's first of all look at traditional teaching. In traditional teaching, content delivery and content acquisition are realized in class, where several dozens of students have to gather at the same time to be entertained by their teacher. In a second phase, students practice on their own, on the basis of additional exercise material, homework task, and so on and so forth. Now we will flip or invert these two activities. So let's do that here. And we will apply the inverted classroom model. Content acquisition is now self-guided. It takes place first and is done online. The additional second phase, the in-class phase, is dedicated to practicing, rehearsing, discussion, analysis, etc. This means that prior to each in-class meeting, students must have worked through the online content of the respective unit. Let us now look at the two phases of the inverted classroom model in detail. Now in phase one, you are now the autonomous learner. You learn at your own time, wherever you want, how long you want, and how often you want. The content you are given is multimodal. It involves all sorts of channels. In all our classes, we supply you, for example, with highly interactive multimedia content, the so-called virtual sessions. In addition to this, you will have the chance to look at video clips, the so-called e-lectures. These are never longer than 15 to 20 minutes and are closely connected with the virtual sessions. Well, furthermore, we have our optional workbooks. Now, these workbooks supply you with the text material of each unit, but not with any other media. And they give you the opportunity to supplement the text with the online content. This combination of multimedia, video and text is unparalleled in the world of e-education. And what about the in-class phase? Well, the in-class phase is now no longer any sort of frontal teaching. So this is clearly out. Instead, the central teaching method is that of a cooperative interaction between instructor and students. And applied to our phonetics class, this simply means practice, practice, practice. Finally, you want to know what you have to do in order to get the class credits. Well, first of all, you have to actively participate, and that's really a prerequisite. Then we offer you the chance to do a large number of ungraded worksheets. These make sure that you have understood the content of each unit prior to each in-class meeting. And on the basis of two graded worksheets and one e-exam, you will eventually be awarded the class mark. This class has been taught before. And in our permanent class evaluations and their comments, our students have been very positive about it. And I'm sure you will like this class too. So, see you on the Virtual Linguistics Campus, see you on YouTube, and if you wish, in our phonetics class.